Verse number 20. Verse number 20. Let me see how I can run this through so that 10 dots were out of the scripture. Verse number 20. Verse 18. Verse number 20, verse 18. Let's read one to go.
Then Jonathan said to David,
Tomorrow is the new moon,
and
thou shalt be missed,
because
thy seat will be empty. Now let's go to 24. So David hid himself in the field, and when the new moon was come, the king sat him down to eat meat. And the king sat upon his seat, as at other times, even upon a seat by the wall. And Jonathan arose, and Abner sat by Saul's side, and David's place was empty. Lift your hands and shout,
O Lord,
empty my seat of death.
Empty my seat of death.
Sit down. Before I say a few things, I just want to prophesy upon every of my son and daughter.
I receive
that God has given me in this land. Every special seat of death that has been organized for you to sit on, I decree you will not be present in that meeting. In that gathering,
yeah.
You will not be present in that meeting.
Yeah.
I don't know the invitation they've given to you. Maybe to attend a meeting in the village, maybe to attend a meeting in Nigeria, maybe to attend a meeting here in East Pabor or any part of the country, and somehow they prepared a special seat that they have diabolically prepared. I prophesy. Because you are an Omega child, because you are untouchable, because your blood is bitter, you will not be present in that meeting. Lift your hands and shout it like thunder. Somebody shout, Lord, empty my seat of death. We were told about a man called King Saul. Saul, as at this time, was the king of Israel. And we were told in 1 Samuel, I think 1 Samuel 19 or so. No, 1 Samuel 17. Goliath confronted the Israelites. And were told that for many days, Goliath held Israel hostage. Nothing was going out, nothing was coming in because of one man. There are some of you, your family, nothing is entering, nothing is going. Any strong man in your family that has held your family hostage, I decree if you shout amen, God will use you to kill them. Somebody that will kill him. He kept shouting. King Saul, produce somebody that can kill me. And we were told that King Saul could not produce anybody. the king could not produce. Because for by strength shall no man prevail. Your father cannot produce a savior. It takes God to raise one. Are you listening to me? It takes God to raise one. The children of Israel suffered for so many years, and God raised Moses in the midst of them. I decree God will raise you in your own family. Yeah. I said God is raising you for your family. Yeah. Tell three persons that are not aware. Tell them God is raising me for my generation. And I told us when I preached the message on because of the anointing, how God selected David, who was in the bush, and anointed him for such a time like this. And we were told that David showed up and killed Goliath. That was the beginning of David's problem. That was what? David's problem began the day he killed Goliath. All this while he has been in the bush, nobody troubled him. All this while he has been in the bush, nobody was looking for him to kill him. All this while he has been in the bush, he was not running from anybody. But the moment he killed Goliath, different kind of challenges started coming. Why? Because the king had seen his future. Because there was a time, how many of you know in politics, when an election is done, it is the highest number that wins the name. Is that true?
Yes, sir.
The higher your vote determines who sits there. There was even a time they came back from war, the community began to sing. They said Saul has slain 1,000, but David has slain 10,000. What was the difference? 9,000. When Saul began to hear such things, something was already telling him, if you don't do something, this world might take over. But there are people they don't want to leave power. As if they brought it from heaven. In life, you must understand that no position is forever. I have the privilege to pastor different branches. Good branches. But go to a time, my pastor, don't say the word. There are some branches you wish you were not transferred from. You get what I'm saying? So you must understand that no position is forever. Because when you have that understanding, the issue of envy, the issue of trying to tell us the next man that is coming, it dies. But because Saul wanted to stay in power forever, he began to fight the next man. Why were they after Jesus? Because a prophecy came that he was going to be the savior, and Herod began to fear. There is a prophecy over your life that you will be the savior of the family.
Amen.
And at this juncture, I want to quickly prophesy. See that whoever that wants to fight your prophecy, may your prophecy kill them.
to draw David very close. When your enemy becomes your friend suddenly.
He saw David now and began to ask David a different question. What family are you from? Then he said, well, my father's name is called Jesse. So he told him, oh, I'd like you to come and stay in my house. Start staying in my house. You know, eat free food. Don't worry, from today.
And David started eating. And the Bible said, everybody in the king's chamber, they had their seats in the dining table. They had their what? Their special seat. And if you're in that house, that is the seat you will sit on until you leave that house. How many of you used to have your seat in your father's house those days? Or you didn't have, you don't know what is dining table? I used to have a seat there, special seat. And so they marked David to that seat. That this seat is for David. This one is for Jonathan. This one is for Abner. This one is for King Saul. So you don't sit on another person's seat. Whenever it is time to eat, you sit on your seat and eat. Said that Saul from that moment, because in 1 Samuel 17 he killed Goliath, and when you move to verse 18, we were told that after he killed Goliath, sorry, chapter 18, after he had killed Goliath in chapter 17, chapter 18 told us that Saul became very jealous. He became very what?
Jealous
of David. And in chapter 19 of 1 Samuel, he began to plan different myths on how to take the life of David. Whenever you discover that there's somebody around you that is becoming jealous of you, be very careful of that person. Be very what?
Careful
of such people. Because anybody that is jealous of you can kill you. Anybody that hates you can eat you. When you begin to notice that probably because of a breakthrough that happened in your life, one person who called himself your friend or herself your friend is becoming jealous, or probably because of a helper, the presence of a helper in your life, they become jealous, begin to avoid those kind of people. Because a jealous man coming close to you is not actually for friendship. He is actually strategizing this on how to hit you. Am I talking to somebody?
Yes, sir.
But it's just that some of us, we are too good at giving people second chance. Let me still be observing. What are you observing? Observing what? You know that this person does not like you. You are still keeping them. Tell somebody, don't keep what will kill you.
Don't keep what will kill you.
There is no friend, there is nobody you have a relationship with that you can't leave if they change. No matter how emotional bonded you are with that person, you can leave them for your own good. Am I talking here? They began to fight David. Was David the only son of Jesse? No! But David was the one God had chosen to take over from Saul. And he had seen it. He began to fight. Some of you may ask, why are they fighting me? It is because you are going somewhere. They've seen you going the only way you are going to. And the only way to stop you is to kill you. but I prophesy.
Receive.
God will spare your life. Saul was fighting David because of his future. The reason you have challenges and stubborn battles is because you have a future ahead of you. Okay, somebody prophet that said, I see they want to kill you. They said, why do they want to kill me? They want to kill you because they've seen your star. The way I attacked Jesus because they saw his star. If you are in this world and nothing is troubling you, nobody is fighting you, it means you are starless. But if you are in this world and you see battles coming from different angles, it means you are starful.
Yes.
Battles are proof that you are going somewhere. Battles are signals. They are spiritual signals to let you know that there is something precious ahead of you.
Amen.
I said to us in one of our services earlier on Sunday, I said, the higher your height, the what?
The better your fight.
Eh?
The better your fight.
The greater your fight. So I don't know. I pray, I fasted, I pray, I still, I tell my sin is not working. My brother is working.
Yes,
he is working, that's why you are feeling that he's not working. Somebody said, I prayed, and that was the same night they oppressed me. That is a sign that your prayer is doing something. Why is it that when you don't pray, nothing happens? They will leave you.
My father, come to me.
Will you slap somebody that has not slapped me?
No, sir.
Eh?
No.
So you have not slapped them, that's why they leave you alone. But the moment you do you are doing something to somebody in the spirit.
Yes, sir.
Of which they can't react as that. But when you are not sleeping, Bible says, when they sleep. What do I do, sir? If they oppress me anytime I finish praying, continue to pray.
Yes, sir.
Continue to what?
Pray.
That is a sign that your prayer
is working.
It has effect. Am I talking to somebody?
Yes, sir.
Tell somebody by your side, you have a future ahead of you. That's why they are fighting. Why are we so interested in your matter? Why? Because you are a person of importance. That is why you need a backup. Because even your enemies, they have a bad goal. That's why you need a backup. Because even your enemies, they have a backbone. Why is your uncle having sleepless night over your issue? Why did they take your picture to the couple, to a shrine, to do something concerning it? Because you are going somewhere and you will get there.
Yeah.
As we enter this week of praise challenge, as you begin to praise God for 2 hours every night this week, I speak to your life. The mountains before you shall become plain. David, as at this point, was just a servant in the palace. happening. Saul was not really after him, Saul was after his future. Because as at that present time, David was nobody. He was just a servant. But sir, I don't have anything now. Why are they troubling me? You have something.
Yes, sir. Yes.
It's not that you think having something means having material possessions.
No. No.
Eh?
Yes, sir.
Some of you, God is to open your eyes to see who you are. You begin to pray for long life.
Yeah.
Some of you that are wishing, hey, let me just die now. And God says, this one doesn't know, you don't know yourself. If I show you who you are in the spirit, what you can. Any man that says, I want to die, is a lazy man.
That's
you lack strength for battle. What you need is strength. If it does not happen, it means there are still many battles to fight. You don't rest because you are tired. You rest until you are finished. I will fight my way until I get there. Fight for the wife. Fight for your family. Fight for your children. Fight for your destiny. It was nothing. But Saul was after his head. I don't know what they've seen ahead of you. And now they are after your head. I decree over your life. I pray for you as your father. I decree over your life. Anywhere they took your name to, the God of this commission shall appear in your favor. They are after you for two things. Number one, it's either you have done what they could not do, or number two, you are trying to do what nobody has done. For trying at all. Look at the life of Joseph. The moment he opened his mouth and said, I have a dream. That was the beginning of his problem.
Yes, sir.
But when he was in the farm with the brothers, there was peace. You like that kind of peace?
No.
Sir, let me be poor. If I don't know which disturbed me. Sir, even if I die poor, so far no witch oppressed me for night. The moment Joseph stood before the brother and said, I have a dream. It's over. People don't dream in this family. And the elders, they went somewhere. Just a dream. What if Joseph had not said, I have a reality?
Uh-huh.
Every power fighting every good dream of yours. They are making sure that that good dream does not come to pass. Whoever they are, wherever they are, they shall die and you will fulfill your dreams. Don't be afraid. Tell three persons around you, I have a dream. How do you know that you are the one God wants to use? God begins to give you big dreams. You don't dream the normal dream they are dreaming. You sleep. They saw themselves in a farm. Harvesting cassava. I saw people bowing down. Your dream is different. God is trying to tell you, you are bigger than this. You are the one I have fashioned right from the beginning of beginnings to use as a voice in this family. I told you every family. What was that? I told you every family has what? A savior. Every family. Every family. No matter where you came from, no matter the village you came from, whether you come from Obiaroko, your family has, there's a savior there. The consolation. Every family. Your family, my family, we have somebody. It doesn't matter the condition of the family. There's a savior. There is somebody God has planted in that family. If the person is not there, it means the person is coming.
Sure.
He said, savior shall come out of Zion. Out of that family is coming out.
Amen.
No sense I used to pray, Father, send help us to my work. No, this says, Father, raise my members.
Amen.
The ones that I'm seeing, I'm raised them.
Amen. 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 Amen.
I was quoting this scripture. But that gentleman, Father, the book says, Savior shall come out of Zion. This one I'm looking for to pay church. Looking for this, looking for to buy this, looking for. Father, you said Savior shall come out of. We have people, living things here.
Yes.
You can make them.
Yes.
Release them. Release them. Bless them. Bless them. That's my prayer, man. In this week of prayer challenge, my focus is you.
Amen.
Raise them. We are not looking for people outside you. Pray. The one we have here, do something with them.
Amen.
How many of you are available for God this weekend? Just devote your time. Don't joke with this instruction I gave you. Just give him praise for 2 hours every night, and you'll be glad you did.
Amen.
How do I escape the seat of death? I'm just saying, be quickly. Number one, you must be sensitive. You must be what?
Sensitive.
It is not. Parties you attend in this type or whatever, anywhere. The Bible said they invited me to come and eat meat. So it was for enjoyment. The invitation was for enjoyment. But at the same time, they had programmed a chair, a special chair for him to sit on. That Satan will organize this year to take your life. I decree over your life, you will be absent. Yeah. Yeah. Devil just woke up one morning and said, I will not go. He used to go before. But he just woke up one morning and said, today, I will not go. He was sensitive in the spirit. People have lost their life in parties, meetings. So there's a burial you need to go for. And you end up becoming the one they buried.
Uh-huh.
I've seen people go to birthday parties only to come back sleep and wake up. Why? They sat on the seat of death. Sensitivity is the mother of longevity.
Yes, sir.
People who live long are sensitive in the spirit. That's why your spirit must be alive. How do you make your spirit come alive? Through fasting and eating the word of God. The flesh wanted the meat, but the spirit was seeing another thing. When your flesh begins to control your spirit, you are on your way to sitting on that seat. But when your spirit begins to control your flesh, you will escape. Because the flesh not the take ear meat. Huh? The flesh loves those things. The flesh loves clubbing. I wonder sometimes when you go to club, how your spirit frowns at you. Your flesh is rejoicing, dancing, but your spirit is angry.
Yes.
The spirit is saying to you, I wish this person know that doing this thing at all, you are killing me. Scripture describes our spirit like a candle. The more you involve yourself in the things of the flesh, you are burning the candle of your life. And when the, how do they call the candle? The wax. When the wax finish burning, what happens to the light? When somebody, when you go to club or you involve yourself in worldly things, your spirit is not happy. Don't be afraid. You are a suspect. That's why you can't open your mouth. Don't worry. Tell yourself. Tell yourself. That's the truth. Your spirit is not happy, right? But your flesh, you see your flesh, they bring casket. Because your flesh has love for it. By which God can open your eyes to see your spirit, the condition of your spirit. That's why you can't pray, because the spirit is down. The Bible made us say, quench not the spirit. How do you quench the spirit? True only lifestyle. The more you involve yourself in those things, the spirit is quenching. And when the spirit finally quenches, the flesh is gone. Because the life of the flesh is the spirit. I'm talking too much. That's what it be sensitive. It is not all food you eat. That's how you wake up in the morning, brush your teeth quickly. Where are you rushing to? Your friends are, because you already know they cook their breakfast 8 a.m. So you don't want to miss it. And they're already planning for you. They always come and shut their eyes up. So they're waiting for you to come and eat. The last one. On that day, you will sleep for a whole day. You will not. You will just wake up so that you will miss the meeting. Number two. You need a man. You need what? The Bible made us understand that it was Saul's son, Jonathan, that exposed the plan of the father to David. And told David, so day, don't come. Because that seat has been marked. Look at it. When God wants to preserve a man, he uses a man. In John chapter 5, verse 7, the lame man screamed and shouted, I have no man. Jesus asked the man, will you want to be healed? And the man started complaining. He said, yes, I want to be healed all these years, but I have no man. Bring it up, John chapter 5. The seven. What did he say?
When the water
is troubled,
to put me into the pool.
I have no man to put me into the pool. This year, that man that will put you into the pool shall appear in the name of Jesus. Change your life, that will preserve you, is coming your way already.
Yeah.
If you shout amen between now and tomorrow, you will meet that person.
Yeah.
If you slap the altar with a seal on your hand, between now and tomorrow, you will meet that person.
Yeah.
Tell somebody you need a man.
Need a man.
If you must escape the seat of death, you must hide yourself. You must what?
Hide yourself.
It is wisdom to hide yourself. It is foolishness to show yourself. In the book of Experience, chapter 10, verse 15, it is wisdom to hide yourself. It is foolishness to show yourself. Stand up, stand up, stand up. Look at somebody. Every person in the book of Experience.
In the book of Experience.
Pat them like you are advising them like you are their father. Say in the book of Experience. Chapter 10. Verse 15.
It is wisdom
to hide yourself. It is foolishness. Do like this. To show yourself. People who don't have time are actually those that like showing themselves. God bless you, small. You are already showing yourself. Modified
or you fight
in disguise. But he didn't show it. Am I talking to somebody?
Yes, sir.
Hide yourself. The first time in Nigeria, I got a laugh. Okay, bro, I told my dad then. I was like, I said, I want to buy a land. He said, yeah. He said, you want to buy a land? He said, no, don't worry. Give me the money. Let me be the one to buy. I will tell people I am the owner of the land. You understand that?
Yes,
he said, hide on my back. He said, don't show yourself. Because he's a letter. He has been there before. He knows people. But you don't agree. No, Papa, they must know that Tukudi has arrived. And what do you want to share yourself? Just to impress somebody. If you die, you become an idiomatic expression. And when they are describing you, they say, you know that boy, he has finally kicked the bucket. Amen. Tell someone, hide yourself. Hide yourself. For those of you that follow Papa, he was advising Africans. He was talking about how to create a future. He was saying, people, like, oh my God, I love my father. I wonder some of what we spend time doing. Go to YouTube, his messages are there. Play them over and over again. He's a coach. He's not just preach the Bible. He teaches you about life. Instead of creating a future, you are trying to impress somebody. And that is some of the problem with Africans in this land. I've seen a video recently, was it today? I had a radar that was there selling it. They picked some boys. Some of you are looking at me, you don't have a clue. You have some boys to your phone. It's not a selling. Yeah. What's mommy? No, I had somebody say that they've gone to a selling. It's Osumambe. Okay, Osumambe or whatever. Black man will get money the first thing. Come on, say you think, how can you call a straight man like and buy a car? And the kind of car you will buy, you will not buy second hand, you go and buy Shabe. You know what Shabe? You go and buy a very big one. And they are wondering, how did this black man get money from? Be black at all. They've already started suspecting you. And now, you now bought. The suspicion is perfected. As some of us who don't let this grow, you have already started going to grow. Those of you, I'll pray for you. And if God opened my eyes to see any of you, anybody I'm pastoring in the club, I will curse you. You will feel it. You will feel the heat of the curse. Because you don't have plan for the money. We have crusades. We have places to reach. You don't know what to do with money. You will carry $10,000, $20,000 to a club, shut the club down overnight. And they are looking for who will pay rent for church for 1 year. And God will judge you. The only thing you remember me for is prayer. Daddy! Lay your hands. your answer. Lay your answer. Today, some of them they are already prepared for visit. They've ironed their sleeve. And we have a program in Cyprus. We need money. Cyprus, they don't have instruments. We are thinking of Eseli. We are thinking of Aksara. There are souls there that their destinies are connected to the grace of police commission. But that's for your concern. That is why police, they will have you so pray they will catch you. They must catch you. If they don't catch you, I will report you myself. I will tell them there was one I saw in the street. Please. This is the address of the person. I'm looking at you. Mommy will enter your hand like this. You will even come and meet me and say, sir. Uh-huh. See where they enter. So that I can partially be covering you. So that they won't see me. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
What am I trying to say? Stop showing yourself. It is children that show themselves. Have a plan for your life. Have a plan for your money. Colossians 3 verse 3. He said, we are hidden in Christ. Psalm 27 verse 5. He said, for in the day of trouble, he shall hide me. Psalm 27 verse 5. Don't look up. In the day. Let's read that point. You want to go? Put your name anywhere your name fits. Want to go? For in the time of trouble, he shall hide this one in his pavilion. In the secret of his tabernacle shall he hide this one. He shall set this one up upon the earth. In the time of trouble. That period when they are after your life, I prophesy. The God of your father, the God of my father, Apostle Joseph Suleiman, he shall hide you. God shall hide your wife. God shall hide your business. God shall hide your destiny. In the name of Jesus. Lift your voice and say, Lord, hide me near
my enemies.
Cannot see me. 2 Kings chapter 6, verse 29. Let's read that and pray. 2 Kings chapter 6, verse 29.
So God has come and did eat him, and has said unto her, give thy son, that you may eat him. And she had hid her son.
She had
hid her son.
The reason they cannot boil you is because God will hide you. Lift your hands and tell your prayer. Lord, hide me so that they cannot boil me. Hide me so that they cannot boil me. There are witches looking for people to boil. Hide me. There are witches looking for people to eat. Hide me. Say, my father, my father. Apostle Joseph
Suleiman,
as I begin to pray,
hide me
so that they cannot boil me.
Hide me
so that they cannot eat me.
Open
your mouth and begin to pray. husband is preserved.
Amen.
Your wife is preserved.
Amen.
Your children, they are preserved.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
God bless you.